Got
it. It's 11:30 on a Tuesday night. There's been a lot of talk about drill rap, drill music, New York City, connecting violence with the culture. And I just wanted to create a conversation with the mayor. We brought Fabio here. We got young Blove here. We got Slow and Bucks here. We got Bleezy here to talk about, you know, what's really happening, so the mayor could get a real perspective and a real understanding of what drill rap is, and so that, you know, we could have some real dialogue and really start to really make things happen.
We're going to roll out something together on the whole conversation, and we're looking forward to it, and I appreciate you, man.
Definitely.
Check it out now. Got the malarkey, man. Now, if you guys don't know, basically, the new mayor of New York City ain't going for none of this New York City drill, okay? This ain't Chicago, people. You can't drop 72 bodies in a goddamn weekend and think that nobody will bat an eye. Not in New York City. Now, the new mayor, which, by the way, he is black. And by the way, only a black mayor could start changing certain stuff around because, of course, it's targeted. And if it was a white guy, we'd just call that guy racist. So the new mayor is black. His name is Eric Adams. And he basically said, yo, we're having a lot more violence, especially from the teens and the youth of urban communities. And it seems like it's been fueled by drill music. We got to do something about it. Now, he actually addressed this recently where he had a quote that stood out where he said, we pulled Trump off Twitter, yet we're allowing music displaying guns and violence to be on these same social platforms. He basically was trying to say he's going to look towards doing something about getting drill music videos banned from social media. Now, I know what you might be thinking. What the hell? Why? Well, here's the thing. And we got to acknowledge what drill is, because I keep hearing people trying to redefine what drill is. Listen, drill ain't party music. Drill ain't music for the club. I know these dudes are spinning like gigs. You know what I mean? They're sashaying. They're gyrating. They're doing everything. But let's keep it real. Drill music is, as the name suggests, it's music to drill to. Music to chase the ops to. Music to kill to. Music to basically beef with other people to. Okay? We could dress it up with anything you want to dress it up with, but you got to just call a spade a spade. Now, is drill music inherently bad? Let's be honest, right? No. Just like any type of music, it depends on the real-world application. I mean, people have been making gangster music for years. But does it mean that every time somebody makes a diss song or a gangster record, 15 bodies drop behind it? No. So here's the problem they're having, especially in New York City, okay? Chicago, that's like a whole, like, Chicago's like a different planet, okay? But in New York City, they can't have people dissing each other on social media and then on records, okay, within drill music, and then bodies dropping days later, okay? They can't have multiple consecutive days where bodies keep getting dropped and it's people that are all involved in music, which leads people to believe that the music is fueling it or the music is basically narrating what the beefs are. So I think this is where they have to come to a mediation. And I'm glad everybody met up, but here's the thing. None of this matters, right, until the guys who are popular in this drill stuff acknowledge that they will not and never again diss the people they actually got beef with. Because the mayor can't stop the beefs. There's people that lost their lives. Whoever they don't like or whoever they're beefing with or their ops, they're going to still not be cool. However, including those type of things in the music overtly, where you're dissing the dead, where you're throwing up gang signs that is dissing the other person's gang sign, and you're basically doing things to antagonize and provoke other sides to do something in retaliation, I think that's what the mayor has to try, if he's going to try to work with these guys, try to work to fix. Okay? Now, it's a very slippery slope. You know why? Because what you're going to usually get is that people are going to sneak stuff by. And honestly, you can't have a half-measured approach to this. I've said it before. You can't be like, okay, yeah, y'all could just keep rapping about killing, but then we're going to expect no deaths because you're not actually naming names and you're not dissing the dead. Inherently, drill music will promote and encourage violence. It is going to either be accepted or you're going to have to fight against it. That just is what it is. And I think the mayor trying to sit down with these guys, he's probably trying to come to a conclusion about it. But let's be real, okay? If the artists there are talking about the music is so necessary for the ecosystem, for the youth, are they willing to get with the person who, or the opposing gang, that's their ops, and say, we're squashing it because we're all making money off the music? let's make, or basically saying, hey, listen, the music now won't have those ramifications of people dying. No, because honestly, and this is the sad part about it, nobody would admit it. Like, the reason why even Chicago Joe got so big is because of the authenticity. You know that when Chief Keef was dissing whoever, he really didn't like him. When so-and-so was dissing so-and-so, when they really saw each other, it would be a shootout. And again, the authenticity and the violence that comes inherently with drill, I'm wondering what type of solution the mayor think he about to come to when he's sitting down with these guys, okay? You know, we've seen Fabio Foreign, who I think he's an elder statesman now in drill. He spoke up for it, and he basically said, yo, I got a song called City of Gods that got Kanye and Alicia Keys. Show love for New York City. I love the city. All we do is try to be positive inspirations for the communities and families. Now, that is Cap Fabio. Come on, Fabio. Like, come on, man. Big drip. I fell in love with a... Like, come on, man. It's a bunch of diss music, bro. Like, come on. I hate when they try to make drill to sound like the Barney theme song. No, what are you guys talking about? This is positive. No, it's not. Okay? The only thing that looked positive is when y'all dancing. And to keep it real, even the dance is actually... It's basically a metaphor for the fuck y'all doing. Y'all are twirling like to pretend that somebody got shot. Y'all are making fun of people getting shot. That's just kind of what it is, all right? Fabio continues to say this is sound in New York. That is very true. He said, we just trying to show the world how far we could go and take it. Don't stop the video from dropping. And this is a problem I keep saying inherently with hip-hop. In hip-hop, people want to be allowed to do the wrong thing till they make it. But this is the problem that later comes in. Even when they've made it, they don't stop promoting the same message. Fabio Foreign has made it. You think Fabio Foreign is going to stop rapping about killing, murdering, and spinning? No, he's not. He's going to keep doing it. So again, there's no exit plan to it. People just really want an excuse to do the wrong thing. And that's just what it is, okay? You know, again, the mayor's dealing with a particular city that hasn't faced a wave of violence connected to music ever like this. Well, actually, I won't say ever, for a while, and that's why they're going to crack down on a whole bunch of stuff. Hopefully, they could come to some type of agreement, but I'm going to be honest, man, the young and the ignorant, I don't think they're going to put down the gun for no apparent reason. And shoot, maybe I'm wrong, though, because maybe the governor threatening to ban the music might actually allow them to stop the violence. Who knows? You guys let me know, man. Do you think that with this happening, the violence will chill? Or is it just a part of drill music? Keep it real. I want to ask y'all too. Would y'all even listen to drill if y'all felt that like it was just empty words? Like, you know what I mean? Again, it sounds sad, but we got to be honest. It's the hypocrisy of hip-hop. Like, a lot of people get rich off a lot of fuckery, but we act like it's all holistic based on just saying, hey, we're coming from a community with not a lot of chances, and this is our chance to get out. But even after we get out, still pumping the same message. Get in the comments. Make sure you guys like, definitely subscribe. What do you guys think about this whole thing? I want to hear your opinions in the comment section. We're Akademiks.